What do you know T-Accounts? Let's find out. I'm James, you're watching Accounting Stuff, and today I've prepared 20 multiple choice questions for you. We'll start with the basics, but don't get too comfortable. Things will get tougher and fast. So grab a pen, keep score, and remember to share your result in the comments at the end. Let's begin. Question 1. An account is a place where a business lists all of its transactions in chronological order, records, sorts, and stores all transactions affecting a related group of items, summarizes its total revenue and expenses, or keeps copies of customer invoices. It's B. An account tracks increases and decreases for a specific category, like cash or accounts payable. Question 2. A T-account is a blank representation of an account. Special, digital, verbal, or visual. It's D. A T-account is a visual representation of an account. It shows you how debits and credits affect each side. Question 3. What does the T in T-account represent? The name of the transaction, the total balance, the shape used to record entries, or the trial balance? The answer is C. It's called a T account because it's shaped like the letter T. Question 4. The account name goes where on a T account? The top, the bottom, the left, or the right? A. The account name is written at the top of a T account. Question 5. Credits are recorded on which side of a T account? The top, the bottom, the left, or the right? The answer is D. Credits always go on the right side of a T account. Question 6. Debits are recorded on which side of a T account? The top, the bottom, the left, or the right? It's C. Debits go on the left and credits go on the right. Question 7. The balance of a T account is calculated by adding all debits, adding all credits, adding both sides together, or subtracting the smaller side from the larger side. D. To find the balance of a T account, you add up each side and subtract the smaller total from the larger total. The difference represents the account's remaining balance. Question 8. If the credit side of a T account is greater than the debit side, the account has a debit balance, credit balance, normal balance, or zero balance. The answer is, of course, B. It would have a credit balance. Question 9. If the debit and credit size of a T account are equal, the account has a debit balance, credit balance, normal balance, or zero balance. It's D. When total debits and credits are equal, they cancel each other out, leaving the account with a zero balance. If you're finding these questions tricky, don't worry. My T-Accounts cheat sheet breaks it all down. You'll find it inside my all-in-one accounting cheat sheet bundle at accountingstuff.com/shop, or just click the link in the description. Question 10. Which type of T-account has a normal balance on the left side? Is it assets, liabilities, equity, or revenue? The answer is A. Assets are represented by the A in dealer, making them normal debit accounts. We'd expect to find their balance on the left or debit side of the T account. Question 11. Which type of T account has a normal balance on the right side? Could it be assets, dividends, revenue, or expenses? It's C. Revenue accounts are represented by the R in dealer, which means they're normal credit accounts. So their balance appears on the right or credit side of the T account. Question 12. Where would you expect to find the opening balance of a marketing expenses T account? On the left or on the right? A. Marketing expenses are a type of expense, so they're represented by the first E in dealer. This means they're normal debit accounts, so their opening balance would be on the left or the debit side of the T account. Question 13. Which side of a T account is used to record an increase in accounts payable? The left or the right? The answer is B. Accounts payable is a type of liability. It's represented by the L in dealer, so it's a normal credit account. This means credits would increase it on the right side of the T account. Question 14. Which side of a T account is used to record a decrease in common stock? The left or the right? It's A. Common stock is an equity account represented by the second E in dealer, so it's a normal credit account. This means we'd debit common stock on the left side of the T account to decrease it. Question 15. Which side of a T account is used to record a decrease in inventory? The left or the right? It's B. Inventory is a type of asset, so it's a normal debit account. This means we would credit inventory on the right side of the T account to decrease it. Question 16. Which side of a T account is used to record an increase in dividends declared? The left or the right? The answer is A. Dividends are represented by the D in dealer, so it's a normal debit account. That means increases are recorded on the left or the debit side of the T account. Question 17. Where would you expect to find the closing balance of a service revenue T account? On the left or on the right? B. Service revenue is a type of revenue, so it's a normal credit account. So we'd expect to find its closing balance on the right or the credit side of the T account. Question 18. A business has an opening balance of $2,000 in accounts receivable. During the month, they receive a $500 payment from a customer. What's the closing balance of the T account? Is it $500 on the left, $1,500 on the left, $2,500 on the left, or $1,500 on the right? It's B. Accounts receivable is an asset, which means it's a normal debit account. It starts with a $2,000 balance on the left side of the T account. When the business receives the $500 payment, they credit the right side to reduce the amount owed, leaving a $1,500 balance on the left or the debit side. Question 19. A business has an opening balance of $12,000 in sales revenue. During the month, they earn $5,000 in revenue and close the account. What's the closing balance of the T account? Is it $5,000 on the right, $17,000 on the right, $17,000 on the left, or $0? The answer is D. This is a bit of a trick question. After earning the $5,000, the total credit balance of sales revenue becomes $17,000. But when the account is closed, it's debited by $17,000. The balance is transferred to the income summary account, leaving sales revenue with a closing balance of $0. Question 20. A business has a closing balance of $9,000 in accounts payable. During the month, they purchase $4,000 of goods on credit and paid out $2,500 to suppliers. What's the opening balance of the T account? Is it $7,500 on the right, $7,500 on the left, $6,500 on the right, or $10,500 on the right? It's A. Accounts payable is a liability account with a normal credit balance. We know the business bought $4,000 of goods on credit. That increases the account. They also paid out $2,500 to suppliers, which would decrease it. To finish with a closing balance of $9,000, the opening balance must have been $7,500 on the right or the credit side of the T account. Bonus question. If total debits in all T accounts equal total credits, what does this tell you? That the business has generated a profit? That all transactions have been recorded correctly? That no errors exist in the accounts? Or that the accounting equation is in balance? The answer is D. When total debits equal total credits, it shows that the business's assets are equal to its liabilities plus equity. This means the accounting equation is balanced, though errors may still exist. How did you go? Drop your score in the comments. You can grab my T Accounts cheat sheet using the link right here. And don't forget to subscribe for more accounting quizzes and tutorials. See you soon.